Hi guys, it's Laura Osnes. Thank you so much for tuning in and joining us for a very special Pride episode of RNH Goes Live. A few weeks ago, we decided to pause our programming in an effort to respect and give space to the voices that truly needed and continue to need to be heard. We promise to keep listening and always work to become better partners. This week, we are so happy to be returning for a performance and conversation with Broadway's Jelani Aladdin and Matt Doyle. Jelani and Matt will be performing We Kiss in a Shadow from Rodgers and Hammerstein's The King and I, a song they originally performed and recorded as part of the RNH Goes Pop series last year. As Jelani said last year, this song is our way of understanding how we can begin to accept love of all kinds. This month, we celebrate Pride all over the world. And here in New York, 2020 is the 50th anniversary of the NYC Pride March. It is so important to celebrate and also to recognize the work that still needs to be done to ensure love, acceptance, and equality for all. Before Matt and Jelani join us, here is a quick peek back at their music video from last year of We Kiss in a Shadow.
Alone in our secret, together we sigh for one smiling day to be free. To kiss in the sunlight and sail in the sky. Hey,
hi, Jelani.
I miss you, buddy.
I miss you too, man. How are you holding up?
You know, this moment in time, I'm doing better than I was in previous weeks.
Yeah.
I think that it's an hour by hour kind of feeling that I'm
right. There like wasn't an earthquake this hour, and that you can actually breathe. That's kind of been 2020 so far. My God.
Yeah, kind of just like. It's forcing me to live in the present, like literally like this moment that matters right now. I have no idea what's going to happen when I leave this moment, but I'm just going to enjoy this moment for right now. You know what I mean?
Right. Absolutely. Yeah. How are you filling your days right now? Like in the very like general COVID sense, what are you doing to like stay busy and stay, not
it's funny
miserable?
Because like, in the beginning I was like, oh, all these people trying to stay be normal, like screw that. I'm just gonna lay on my couch and eat chips all day and watch movies and not do anything. And I allowed myself to do that. I was like, I need to take the time to do that. But then I did this like reading of a bunch of new, of cool of a I did like a playwright competition on my Instagram. It inspired me to like get up and like do again. And since then I've basically started a production company. I've been writing my face off, my hands off rather. And I'm starting to pitch some things to people and trying to get work done that is about my experience and the Black experience as a collective and human experience as a collective beyond just being about a Black artist. And so I'm excited for those things to continue to grow and flourish, but that's what's taking up all my time. I'm learning a lot.
Yeah.
Just as much as, you know, I feel like other people are learning about, you know, social issues and Black culture. I'm over here, you know, learning how to film
and
how to produce theater and working on adaptation of Hamlet and this book and that book.
Yeah.
It's my Kindle's filled with a bunch of books. And I'm reading than I ever had before. How are you?
Good. That's amazing. First and foremost. And like, I think this is such an important year. I think the shift is happening for everyone right now. Like I definitely started in the same exact mode. I went into total shutdown. There was such a moment there where we really thought it was just going to be a pause too. And that is like done, you know, we know that theater's not back until next year. And it's just like, all right. So instead of sitting on our couch, kind of wallowing in it. And, you know, I was eating like I've never eaten in my life. And exercising.
I'm still on that part. Like, I'm still on that part.
Oh my God. I mean, I just like threw all my routines out the window. And that was nice. Like in a weird way, it actually was, I think, healing to have a moment of that, because as actors, and you know this, we're so hard on ourselves, and we put so much pressure on ourselves 24/7. So to just like completely drop from the world and not be expected to go anywhere or do anything was, I think, healing. And then, you know, I think it really started to turn when all of the social issues are happening now and finally getting light, and this unbelievable movement really started to become, you know, so present. That was the feeling of like, I got to get off my couch, you know, I have to start doing something and I have to be present myself. And I think I've just been trying to do things for myself and also do things for community and do things for my friend. I'm writing as well. I write comics. So I just started writing a new comic.
I know you. I know.
Yeah.
I know everything about Matt Doyle. I mean, it's so funny right now. Like this moment of even when we back when we were making the video. When did we make that video? When was the last?
Oh gosh, that was like last year.
And I just like remember being like, God, remember that, like how weird is it that I used to like geek out about people like Matt Doyle and like these amazing Broadway stars, and then here I am, God. Yeah, we're gonna sing a duet together. Like what is life?
I'm so old.
There's nothing about you that I probably don't know. So that's what I'm saying.
You're ridiculous. I write comics, and honestly, like it's the little things in a moment like this that as I'm writing an outline for a comic and reassessing it and going, have I given voice to enough diversity here? Both, you know, sexuality, but people of color in my comic, all sorts of things on that level. And then, you know, looking towards the future, when Broadway does come back in 2021, making sure that my unbelievable cast and company of company continues to do the work there too. And we've had some really incredible conversations, and I'm really hopeful that this is a meaningful moment right now, and that people are learning and listening in a way that they haven't before. And I know that I've made mistakes already, you know, and I'm just continuing to stay patient with myself and make sure that I never get defensive and make sure that I'm open and continue to listen. And yeah, that's like my current life right now. It's a lot of writing, finally working out again, and trying to do better, to be completely honest. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Absolutely. I hear you. I feel you. It's a health of mind, a health of body, a health of spirit, you know, those things are well. And speaking of health of spirit, something has been helping me is singing.
Yeah.
It's kind of like, you know, finding moments, just be like, not even singing for like a performance kind of thing, but like in the shower or like taking a walk around the block and be like, I just want to sing a song to myself to kind of minister to myself in a weird way and feed myself.
Yeah.
You know, that has been incredibly helpful. When we got the chance to revisit We Kiss in a Shadow,
I know.
I was like, I have to go back listen to the video.
I know. But also I was so proud of what we did going back and looking at it again. I mean, talk about something that I know that you and I had all the right intentions when we were working on that originally, and I wanted it to be about diversity, and I wanted it to be a song about a queen, and I wanted it to be a song about not having to hide anymore, and I wanted everything that we worked on is like, now I look at it, and even then, of course I was proud of it then, but with everything happening right now, I'm like, I'm so, so grateful that we did that. And I'm so grateful that you lent your voice to that, and that we found such a wonderful chemistry working on that video together. And it's a really important message right now, especially within the gay community, which has a lot of its own prejudices and everything. And I've been aware of it and probably not spoken out enough in the past about it to demonstrate that message, a message of diversity and love. Yeah. My sister is in an interracial couple. I'm about to have a black niece or nephew, and I want to make sure that I don't know, that I'm listening and learning and doing the right thing and trying to be there for a community that is now very much a part of my life as well. So
of course, you know, the the trick is when you go to revisit a song, you never actually end up singing it the way you sang it before because it was up past.
Yes.
So I was excited that we got to revisit We Kiss in the Shadow and I don't know, make it right.
Yeah. And just also to revisit the arrangements and revisit these lyrics again. Think about, like I said, the work that we did on it and that I'm really genuinely so proud of what we created. And it was just so nice, especially right now, to recognize how important this song still is. And I'm so glad that we get to do this. Obviously, with the constraints of Zoom and everything, we couldn't do it live, but we were able to put together something on our phones back and forth.
What are you talking
seems
about?
Seems to be the trend these days.
I don't know what you're talking about. This is live, everyone. This is a live recording of We Kiss in the Oh, please enjoy it. Yes. Ignore what Matt Doran said. This is live.
Okay.
The moon, our meanings are few and over too soon. We speak in a whisper, afraid to be heard. When people are near, we speak not a word. Oh, alone in our secret, together we sigh for one smiling day. To be free, to kiss in the sunlight,
singing that.
And say to the sky, behold and believe what you see, behold how my lover loves me. Ooh. Alone in our secret, together we sigh for one smiling day. To kiss in the sunlight and say to the sky, behold and believe what you see, what you see, behold how my love
Jelani, every single time you do that, to be free, and then you have that clean, gorgeous, straight-toned riff, I cannot, it's rude. You are so, so talented. I love your
voice. You're very kind because I'm watching it being like, oh, that was rough.
No, I don't know what I did at the very end of that. I was trying some new riffs. But I just adore your voice, and it is such a thrill to sing with you.
Oh, thank you. Making music is like the highest form of creation, I feel like. And though we're like apart, we're still able to do that. And I think it's really cool. And just to watch it come together is really, really fantastic. And that song always touches in a very tender place.
Yeah.
And I hope that that people watch it and they're seen.
Yes.
They know that they're seen and they're loved.
That's the goal. That was the original goal of the song too, and that's what's so nice about bringing it into a more contemporary context and or just a different context, honestly. And it's so moving to get to work on it again with you.
Yeah, I mean, I look forward to the day when a song like that doesn't have meaning anymore.
I know.
To be quite honest,
or where a song like that and two men and interracial is not an interesting thing to do. That it's just,
oh my God, never been done before. You're like, wow. No, this the truth of so many people, and we're just
of so many people. And to get there, you have to just keep giving to those stories. And that's why it's so amazing that you're starting to produce and doing the work. I mean, that's unbelievable.
Yeah. I mean, it's because also it's like, I've never been one to kind of wait for anyone to do anything for me. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's just been my life. So it's like, if there's something that needs to be done, then I will go find the resources to do it. There are resources out there, you know?
Yes.
And And so, I don't know. I just, also, in singing the song, the arrangement of it was just so cool. Moody, that's not the right word.
Soulful?
The song, soulful, it's like a precious, like, fruit that you're just like, and you can take a bite in it, and you're just like, damn, that's good. You know
it's
what I mean?
It's haunting, like, it really is. I mean, it moves in a way that slowly opens more and more. And I love that about our arrangement. And it's such a special song, too. The fact Will Van Dyke, our arranger, did such a beautiful job. But the fact that those words are just so incredibly universal and can speak to so many people who love, who hide their love and feel like they need to hide their love for so many different reasons. And I think we were able to, touch on a lot of ways that people their love and in our video and in our scenario, but still those words could be placed into so many different scenarios, which is what's so incredible about the song.
I mean, that lyric alone is just like, give it to me, I want it.
and
here we are in June. It's Pride Month.
I know,
and it's the 50th anniversary of the NYC Pride Parade in here in New York, but of course it's not happening. But I do hear some ramblings of some virtual events happening to celebrate Pride, I think probably at end of this week or next week. But, what does this song mean to you right now? What does Pride mean to you right now?
Pride means right now, I think, connecting in a way that we haven't connected before. We're finally listening to each other. One of the things that's so amazing is while the parade isn't happening, 50th year is not happening outside, marching is happening outside. This month has been given to such an incredible movement, everything that's happened this month, and I'm so grateful for that, and so aware of that, so proud of that. And that has become a part of Pride for me, is finally listening to voices in our community that need to be heard and need to really, really be listened to. Because so many times white gay male in my past, I think I have, especially growing up in the Obama era, where so many of us were very,
I think that was the most prideful moment.
We were very privileged, and we were fighting for gay marriage at the time, and we were thinking ourselves like we had tackled other issues already. And now it's so apparent that we have so much work to do. And it's a shame that so many of us were not awake to that. But I am guilty in the past of thinking that my oppression as a white gay male is similar to the oppression of a black gay male. And that is not true. And that I have carried around my white privilege, not necessarily recognizing just the extent of what's been given to me. Just by being, and it's a really important thing that I think we recognize our peers within the gay community, people of color, and finally look at the issues within our own community and how to be more accepting within our own community, this pride. And that's what's so wonderful about this pride, I think.
Yeah, I mean, to be honest with you, I don't think I've ever, the word celebrate, pride has never been a time for me to celebrate.
Wow.
I've never felt, you know, in terms of white queerness and black queerness and trans, the trans community, I never felt that it was a true celebration because there's still so much work to be done that I was like, how can we celebrate? How can we celebrate this right now when it's just like, actually, I can't go to your boat party. I can't go to, you know, your circuit party on the beach because I have nothing to celebrate. I'm not fully inclusive. The equality is not the same until members of our trans community can walk the streets free and loving. And
absolutely.
And until all races can feel that they have a seat at the table of love. I mean, then I will celebrate pride. But I am proud of the work that is being done to get there.
Yes.
Because it starts, and if we cannot be proud that people are at least working towards that, then we're doing ourselves a disservice, right? So I always say I remain guardedly optimistic.
Yeah, I know you're making me emotional just because I recognize it, and I recognize that there's so much work to be done, and I you've been such an incredible voice through this. By the way, I've been following you on all the social medias. So ridiculous to say, but
No, it doesn't. That's our way of connecting right now.
Yeah, I am so moved by the things that you've said and how you've been, and I think that's so important right now. And I can't imagine being younger and having being even in high school when I was such a musical and looking up to a voice like yours in the community. It would be just really, really amazing to take that on, because as an adult, I'm watching that. And so think about the kids you're influencing, Jelani. It's really incredible.
Thank you, friend. Thank you, friend. But yeah. We do it all together. We do it all together. And we kiss Absolutely. In a shadow. I just want to put that out there. So please don't.
Did we not kiss when we shot that?
Oh, wait, we did. Oh, wait,
I think we did one full kiss. But then we were like, that's like much at the end. Like, it's just two on the nose. But I think we did. I think we got in a real kiss.
Okay. All right,
yeah. Well, it was a lovely kiss, Jelani.
I don't remember it, so I don't know if I felt the same. but I'm sure it was. I'm messing with you, Matt. I like messing with people so much. Matt's incredible. The kiss was incredible. You're incredible. Everything's incredible. The song is incredible. Rodgers and Hammerstein is incredible. And this movement, and this rights movement, and this Black Lives Matter movement, and these Black Trans Lives Matter movement, and the world moving together is incredible.
Yes. I mean, one thing that's so unbelievable about this year is that we've been allowed the time to listen right now due to everything that's going on with COVID, which is just so, so horrible in its own right, but it's forced us with all this time on our hands and no distractions to really listen to one another. And that's what I'm trying to do. You know, there's something that I'm avoiding right now, which is kind of performative activism, which is something that is an oxymoron in itself. It's not activism if it's performative, but you know, I want to actually do the work. And I think that making sure that we are connecting with our producers, right? Because Broadway is systematically flawed and systematically racist from the top down. And that's something that we need to work on. We need more people of color in every single channel of Broadway, whether you're talking about marketing, theater owners, producers, we need to make sure that that changes so that accessibility can as well. And I know that that's something that every one of us can work on, something that we can do just by picking up the phone and talking to our producer and saying, so what can we do? What kind of programs can we introduce on the other side of this? What kind of performances for different different sides of the public? How can we market differently? You know, just there are so many steps that we need to be taking. And so I, for one, am trying to do the work on that level. And then I'm just like floored by the work that you're doing, obviously. But that's really important right now is I see a lot of things happening on social media right now, which is like, I retweeted 5 people or I posted 5 things today and there I'm a good ally. And I'm like, let's do the work though. You know, there's a lot of work to be done.
Yeah, my whole thing is about in your own words. It's like, do it in your own words, in your own way.
Yeah.
And I think people are really latching on to that because,
yeah.
And I think people, you know, it's so crazy how we were programmed to feel powerless, yeah. And it's we're not. We. This is a nation for the people, by the people, made by the people, and we the people have the power to change all that we want to change to create the equality, to of whomever we want to love, just to stand in the sun and experience it. Isn't that a lyric from the song? What is it?
For one shiny day to be free. Is that
it's to kiss in the sunlight, to kiss in the sun.
And say to the sky.
Behold and believe what you see.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It's timeless. And I hope that
that's for sure.
I hope there comes a time where we prove that lyric wrong.
Mm-hmm. That it does, it feels dated. Wouldn't that be nice? felt dated, but how amazing that it doesn't from the perspective of the writers, that's for sure.
Right.
Well, So where people, because you obviously have so many resources and I've been seeing a lot of what you've been posting. Where can people donate right now that you think are some really important channels?
I personally think that if you want to donate right now, the best place is to anything that services education.
Yeah.
That services, because you actually will see your money going towards something or someone.
Yeah.
Rather than, you know, a large organization we have no idea how that money's being divvied up. But we know that if it's through, you know, there's the Thurgood Marshall Foundation, there's my program that I attended for high school called A Better Chance, these places where the money will be to students. And I believe that the only way to fix this is to get people educated, to get people knowledge about things. And so that for right now is, I think, the perfect thing. But I can already tell you that in about 2 or 3 months, there's going to be so many booming, starting Black businesses, especially in our industry. I know a lot of my friends are starting their own companies. I've started my own company. Then it'll be the time to be like, oh, here are actual voices that we can actually lift up that are creating stories that include everyone. You know what I mean? That include everyone. And so I'm excited for that to arrive, but there has to be work to be done before that can arrive.
I'm excited as well. I'm excited to return to work on the other side of this because my God, have we learned a lot as just like about ourselves throughout this process and also just, there's so much work to be done on the other side, but I'm excited to do it. I'm excited to be engaged and make sure that we keep it going and that it's not a trend, you know, that it's not just this movement that we look back on and go, oh, did that lead anywhere? It needs to change.
This is different. I feel it in my bones. I feel this.
Yeah. Yeah. Amazing. It's so good to see you.
To see you. Yeah. Yeah. True. You're like legendary Matt Doyle. I'm over here just like,
I can't stand you. What are you talking about? That is the most ridiculous thing ever. Like, Jelani, come please. You have frozen under your belt. You're hurt.
Can I get a little bit of your fast wedding rap? I mean, just like, I just need like 5 seconds of it.
Oh, gosh. Oh, God.
Please.
I'm not allowed to do it public. No. I mean, the little part of me is everybody there, because if everybody's there, I want to thank you all for coming to the wedding. There you go.
You know, they had asked me to come in to audition for your husband.
Oh, really? You would have been so sweet. Oh, it would have
been so sweet. If I had known again, I would have gone. I would have been like, yeah, totally. You know.
yeah, I would have loved that. I love my
Itai. Yeah, he's wonderful. He's wonderful.
So great. Yeah.
That is so cool, guys. Well, that was Matt Doyle, guys. That's Matt Doyle, right there.
I'll kill you.
I'm just a Broadway nerd at heart. Like, yeah, I'm a nerd.
Yeah. Aren't we all? I think I saw Rent like 21 times when I was a kid.
Okay, I've never seen anything more than twice, but that's incredible.
Yeah, I used to sleep out stage door every time. Oh, yeah.
Wow. Well, yes. Well, I hope that you stay safe. And
yeah, you too.
Continue to expand. We're all expanding. And
yes.
I'm excited for that. I'm excited to give you a big old hug.
I know. I'm so excited to give you a hug on the other side of this. I think, yeah, that's the thing, is be patient with one another and just keep listening. I'm trying. And I want to do the work, and I want to keep doing the work. And that's the best that we can do right now.
We're all doing. Yeah. We're all doing.
Yes, absolutely. Well, sending you so much love. It's so good to see you. Bye, Jelani.
Bye.